Oh, yeah.
Oh, which means, I don't know, maybe that is actually right. I don't know.
I think it is exactly right, because...
Interesting, yeah. That matches up.
Yeah.
So maybe this is actually totally fine then.
That actually works.
Yeah, so maybe that's actually totally fine. So maybe we should just...
Yeah.
I take that back.
So again, we still haven't solved this issue about how we communicate our unique expertise. Our competitive advantage.
I think you have to have actual screenshots or mock-up or something like that to show that these are your actual products, because the generics I don't think are cutting it. Even if it's just a...
But we've already done the what the three products are here.
Yeah.
So Brian, why not use those three? Go to the sixth one.
Because then people are referencing what they've already seen, and it's going to trigger a memory.
So you have those three on the top three, but as you talked about, replace it with the picture.
I would say just keep it at those three blue things,
yeah.
The charts. Have those three there. Because people have already seen them, and you're talking about the exact same thing.
Actually, yeah, if you go back to that last slide,
Best in class
sales team.
It's obviously on a presentation.
You know, 200 years of cumulative experience.
He's a good guy. He works closely with Mark.
Yeah.
Whatever you use as your kind of metrics, I would maybe just put those just under as like two bullet points under each one.
As opposed to these.
And you know, Brian, what you didn't say is, because you reach a ceiling of $4 million sale, it could not scale. It has to be on computers.
Yeah.
You did not mention this.
That was the one thing I was going to bring up too. Is my question was, why are you getting into this business because you're already successful, and are you disrupting yourself? Those were my questions.
And that was one of my notes, because I know you know, and we did it kind of earlier today, but you didn't mention really emphasis enough on that 1990, that timeline slide, on why you launched Everyone's a Caregiver. So you didn't emphasize enough, okay, we've hit our ceiling here, there was nowhere else for us to move, technology is advancing, budgets are being, like, whatever you want to say surrounding that, make more emphasis of that. On the timeline slide.
Yeah. Your first line, Brian, you said we've been in business for 34 years. We've been around for 34 years, where it was. Which implies it's not a new startup company. The first thing you said.
So defining custom learning has been around for 34 years.
So the parent company, where?
Right.
And now we've branched off. One more thing. Your first two sentences of anything you said completely threw me off. Mother, you're referring to that, which is great, but... my mother, giving her a little bit more personality, a little more depth there. Like, in one sentence. Because you said mother versus my mother.
Which makes sense, because you probably refer to her as mother.
Mother.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's what my kids say in a snarky tone of voice.
Mother.
Anyway,
that
overall, very well done, I'd say.
Yeah.
So these are nits being picked.
we're getting heavily into the weeds.
Yeah.
We want to be in the weeds.
Like, if you presented that tomorrow,
you'd be.
I don't want to be good. I want to be great.
Well, exactly. So we're at very good.
We're nitpicking here. One more thing. You mentioned when you were, again, back to that timeline slide of the 1995. You mentioned we've hit, you know, $4 million in revenue. Blah blah blah. I wouldn't say our revenue from that. I would just build on, again, that ceiling or whatnot.
Why?
Because are you limiting anything by saying that? I don't know, industry experts?
$4 million means a $12 million company. That's it.
So if you're $4 million or whatnot, why are you not funding this yourself?
Yeah. Which is my question, my whole discussion about today.
Yeah.
When I
asked
that.
A different discussion.
No, but this is one of the perception. Yeah. This is one of the perception I was talking about.
Yeah, in the perception, that's exactly
the
word.
Like,
it
if you look at
perceived.
This, what they are missing. These people are away from, like, to be a customer to you as a district venture. These people have the knowledge. They have the links. They have the ins.
Mm-hmm.
What is missing? Where's the technology risk, the market risk? They even have people from the market customizing and telling them how the app should look like. And they have commitment of early adopter. So where exactly, I was asking a question. Where exactly is the gap?
Yeah.
Like when I come to you with any of my sensor company, we have a market risk. We don't know if the product really will fit. We have a longer market cycle. We have some risks here. TRL levels, this is our TRL level 7-8. This is not. Although they don't have a mobile app yet. They don't have any technology yet.
Right.
So this is what one of the discussion today we had in the morning is, where exactly, truly, among us only here in the room, what exactly is the missing part?
Yeah.
And we couldn't conclude.
Yeah, I know that's what Keenan had asked. I remember one of the first presentations I think that you guys had done, and Keenan was there and he was like, holy crap, you guys have love. Are you sure you need this? And I was like, Keenan!
And I think this question needs to be answered in a way, because this would be most likely a question.
Yeah. So what specifically do you guys need as help? Also, if you don't want questions around, why aren't you self-funding, then maybe don't mention that the kind of the value of or the revenue of customers. You can say, we have previously built a very successful consulting-based company. I think most people understand that there are limitations to even how many employees, because even for you guys as a senior management team, at some point, if you hired 300 consultants, you're no longer getting to do what you love, right? You're just managing people, right? So why are you looking to leverage technology rather than just looking hire more people?
I love the word limitations. I think instead of hitting a ceiling, hitting that limitation,
yeah.
I think that's a great way to integrate.
Yeah.
What do you
think? Also don't really want to talk about hitting ceilings, because then people are like, is there a ceiling on this too?
Fair
so but
limitations.
It's kind of like,
self-imposed ceiling.
Yes.
Yeah.
But you want to kind of say, we've been really successful with this, and we see an incredible opportunity through technology scale the impact of what we've been able to do in person.
One other question, and just make sure your facts, you said we've been in partnership with Blue Ocean for 10 years, it's been about 4 years. Just wanna, not sure that's a big deal, but. Two presentations ago, we were talking about ROI and margins, which are extremely high. Is there any value in mentioning the margins? Because it's pretty much sell the stuff, like, on some of them it's a 70-80% margin.
Yes.
So that's something I noticed that we've taken out in our efforts to reduce. We've taken that aspect out of it. Is there value to put that back in?
If I look at a service company, I know the margins are 50%. If I look at a tech company, they're 80.
80 to 90.
So that's just a given.
It's pretty common. It's like, what can you get for your company? Well, I could give you 3 times revenue or 5 times EBITDA. People know these multiples and stuff, so I don't think that would be news to anyone.
Yeah.